you become, the better your business will, you know, will grow. So I'm going to bring Janine on. She's going to talk a little bit about the book that they have and how it can help you really grow your business. And, you know, it might be something that you guys are interested in doing, maybe get some copies, you know, just so that you have them. And then we will go back to talk after she shares. We'll share a little bit more about what's going on. But everything is really rocking. I got to tell you guys are doing a great job, you know, growing your business. But boot camp is going to be that place, you know, to press that hard reset. But so I would make sure that you really have your story, you know, solid, your business story, your product story. You know, that's what people are looking for. Last night, Kimberly and I were together with two of her friends, and all I did was tell the story, you know, and the story, you know, I focused on different things, talking to the ladies that I was talking to. Each lady was different. Each lady had a different outcome. But that's why her Flip-Flop CEO book is a great resource for you as well, because we always know that the person that's most resourceful always wins. So, Janine, I'm going to go ahead and pass it on over to you, and then you guys stay on the line. We'll talk a little bit more about what else we got going on. So I'm going to pass it on over to you, Janine.
Thank you, Lauren. I so appreciate it. I am so grateful to have this opportunity. It is my absolute passion to raise the awareness and the legitimacy of our profession. And as we all know, there are a lot of people that don't really understand it. And I am one of those people that did not, for a long time, get it. And talking about stories, I'll start with mine. The reason we wrote the Flip-Flop CEO, my daughter and I, is because of our own story and our own experience. My daughter is the one that absolutely got it immediately, got the brilliance of this business model. And I was one of those people that absolutely refused to listen to anything she had to say. I had had my own experience 35 years ago when somebody tried to recruit me into a network marketing company and did it actually in a way that people back then were taught to do. And I was invited over to somebody's house for dinner. And when I got there, I found out I was expecting it to just be me. When I got there, I found out there was a room full of people, and the kind of the projector came out, the screen came down, and all of a sudden it turned into this presentation about network marketing. And I was very turned off and just really offended by the kind of bait and switch tactic. And so it kind of scarred me for life. So when my daughter was so excited about what she had found and came home and told me about it, I refused to listen. So we had a year of just battling and, you know, arguing and being on opposite sides of the spectrum. And to be honest, I wouldn't even listen to anything that she had to say because I had had my own experience and I thought that that's the way network marketing was. So because of our experience, once I did the research and found out that a lot of things had changed since then, and that just because one person did something that wasn't really professional and appropriate doesn't mean that the whole network marketing model should be tossed out the window. And so because of that, we wrote the book because we really, I mean, it is my absolute passion to set the record straight and have more people. I almost missed the very best thing that has ever happened to me career-wise because of my negative impression. And so we wrote the book to set the record straight. And the book is really written to speak to smart, savvy, professional women. Men like the book too, but it really is written to connect with that person. It's written to connect with the skeptic. And this is the copy of the book if you haven't seen it, but it's a really kind of a sassy book. It reads like a girlfriend-to-girlfriend conversation, and the reason it works is because it really connects with the skeptic. It calls out the elephants in the room and really talks about one by one. It just talks about all of the objections. So what I found out recently, though, what I've learned is that a lot of people in network marketing that have been buying the book, and it's very generic. The book is about network marketing. It's not about a particular company. A Lauren is in the book. We have two other people from Juice Plus that are in the book. We don't mention company names. The book is to talk about network marketing and to dispel the myths. And what I found, though, is that a lot of leaders were buying the book to give to people that had promoted. So it's really being circulated and used among network marketers. And our intention was for the book to be given to skeptics. I mean, we really just wrote this book so that people that are in network marketing could hand it to a skeptic and let it do the talking for you. And so what I found is that we just haven't done a very good job of teaching people how to use the book and, you know, are bad. So that's what I'm wanting to do is really teach you how to use the book. And my vision is by talking to other companies, to people that are in network marketing, a rising tide lifts all boats. And more of us that can be out there really enlightening people about what our profession is and what it is not helps all of us. So
real quick, I just wanted to let everybody know that those of you that stay on the call, I just took a picture of everybody that's on. All of you that are on, I will buy you each a book. So so that just all of you that are on, I took a picture of who is on, and so you guys will get a copy of the book. So I'll get those back.
And please, if I say anything that anybody has a question about or, you know, wants to add anything, please, I would love for this to be interactive. So if I say something that doesn't make sense, you know, let me know. So what I want to do is really teach you how to use the book, but why to use the book in the first place is really important too, because I think until we have a real conversation with someone about network marketing, we can't really begin to share our business. I mean, a lot of times I think we have a conversation with someone and their perception of network marketing is not the same as ours. And so if we just go right into talking to them about our business, they're, you know, if their walls up, nothing that we say is going to get, they're not going to listen to us because they are objecting really from the get-go. And the thing that is really nice about using a book is that it takes you out of the equation. I think a lot of times what happens is we just start talking and talking and we may not even be addressing the concern that someone has. And a book is objective, it duplicates. So the nice thing about using a book as well is that somebody that's brand new to the profession or somebody that's seasoned in the profession can still use the book. And what it does, it really, really works. I've had so much feedback, once somebody really listens to all of the things that, all of their objections and then has the truth, shared with them to each of those objections, they completely, the walls come down and they change their mind and they're open and they understand. And I think that it allows us to, get out of debate, a debate situation. The other thing is I've heard some people use the book and they think they want to try to memorize all the things that are in the book and memorize all of the answers to the objections. And really what I encourage you to do is use the book, don't use the tool, don't try to be the tool. Because again, it's so nice to take yourself out of the equation. And basically, the other thing is that I think, and you all probably experience this, in our business, we really are representing two things. We have the products and we have the business. And they're really kind of two different things. And I think what happens is a lot of times, especially with a company like yours, you guys have such amazing products and there's so much to teach people about your products. I think what can happen is a lot of times people become much more comfortable talking about the products or the business. I happen to be somebody that is absolutely, I can't wait to tell everybody I know about the business because I think it's so important for people to understand residual income. But a lot of times what can happen is people become more comfortable with one or the other. And so if there are people that you know on your teams or you, and you feel a lot more confident in talking about the products than you do about the business, this is a great way to bridge that gap. And it's a great segue to help you talk about the business. because I think a lot of times it can be hard to know how to initiate a conversation with certain people. So I'm going to tell you how to use the book, and I'm going to sound like really crazy intense about this, but honestly, it's super important. The way that you set this up can make all the difference in the world to this being a great resource to help you build your business. So I'm going to explain to you that exactly how to use it and who to use it with. But what happens a lot of times, and I've heard this from so many people, they'll hand somebody the book and ask them to read it. And when that happens, the person takes the book home, they sit it on a counter somewhere, and it never gets read. So it's really important to be very intentional about it. And what you want to do is when you give somebody the book, you want to ask them to read the first three chapters of the book and then get back with you. So reading the first three chapters takes maybe 30 minutes, and it's a super easy read. I mean, most people, when they're asked to read the first three chapters of the book, will read the whole book. When they come back, they say, I know you only asked me to read the first three chapters, but it was easy, and I went ahead and read the whole book. So what you want to do is ask them to read just the first three chapters of the book and then set up a time to get back in touch with them. And what that does, if they commit to doing that, most of the time, and I will add, do you think you could do that in the next week? Why don't we get back together again next Monday at the same time, and we can, I would love your honest feedback about this. So it's really important to be super intentional, set up the next meeting, and really get their commitment. And if you call somebody before, if they agreed to read it in a week and they haven't, or you call them to see if they have, if they haven't, a lot of times they'll feel really bad about not doing it. And they'll say, okay, I promise I'll do it. And you can give them another week. But it's what happens is that nothing's going to happen until they read the information in this. When they read the first three chapters of this book, their mind opens to network marketing. They change their negative perception, or if they've had any experiences like I did, they that goes away because they understand the brilliance of this business model. But it's only going to happen if somebody actually reads the book. So we've got to figure out a way to get them to open it and to read it. So the people that it's really good for. The book is great for brand new reps. And when we wrote the book, it was really inspired by the fact that when I was first sponsoring my business partners, what would happen is they'd be so excited when they were signing up, and then they would go home and somebody at home, their spouse or their mom or their friend, somebody at home is going to throw buckets of cold water on them and say, oh my gosh, you're not going to do one of those things. And basically they become deflated. I mean, they were so excited about what they were doing, and all of a sudden they're questioning themselves. So what we really wanted to do was empower them. We wanted to give them. So here's this brand new person that has no idea that this is what they're going to encounter. And they're you know, rather than have this happen unexpectedly, it's so much better to equip them with this. And, you know, you can say to somebody new, there might be some people, your husband, your wife, your mom, your sister, your neighbor may not understand the business. There are a lot of exceptions out there. Take this with you and ask them to read the first three chapters and then have a conversation with them. Tell them that you really want their feedback. And I know that a lot of times it's scary to ask for people's feedback, but honestly, I've got to say that that is the way that I have always set this up and have gotten a really, really great response, because people are surprised by how much sense this business makes when they are really walked through it. So it's great for anybody in your support group. We all have people that we would like to be on our side in what we're doing and to not be pushing against us. So it's a great way to create more connection with family and friends. And anybody that you would like support from that doesn't understand what you're doing, or anybody that you want to initiate a conversation with and you just don't know how. So some of those situations could be with coworkers, people that you hang out with who are always talking about, they're looking for a way to stay home with their kids or to retire more comfortably or to go on more vacations or to help their spouse not carry such a heavy load with responsibility. So there's always people that, you know, we are listening to their story, and we are solution providers. So there are a lot of people that are asking for this, but sometimes we don't know how to bridge that gap. If there's somebody that you really admire and respect, those are people that you can get referrals from. So really, people that are on your chicken list, everybody's got a chicken list. There's somebody that you think would be the most amazing business partner, but you just have no idea how to talk to them about the business. So basically, some of the verbiage that you can use is, if it's somebody that's brand new, they can say, I'm not good at explaining this yet, but I think it's a brilliant concept. I'd love your honest feedback. I'm not going to be able to explain it well, but this book, if you read the first three chapters, it will give you the basic idea of what I think is so brilliant. Would you read the first three chapters of this? It'll take half an hour. And then get back with me because I really want to know what you think about it. And you can say to some people, the person maybe that you're talking to that's always saying they want something and you know that this could be a solution for them. I have no idea if this would be a good fit for you, but when you keep talking about wanting to stay home with your kids or helping your spouse, I can't help but think this might be it. Will you do me a favor and read the first three chapters? It's the only way that I'm going to know whether or not it's a good fit for you. And I want your honest feedback. If it's not, no worries. But I keep thinking about you as you talk about wanting to stay home with your kids or whatever. Or you can say to someone, I'm so excited about this, but maybe I'm crazy. I'd love your take on it. If you're talking to a coworker, you could say, I'm doing something that I really didn't know that much about, and I think it's brilliant, but maybe I'm crazy. Could you read the first three chapters and let's talk about it? I'd love to get your honest feedback. And to that person that you really admire and respect, you know, you're somebody that I admire and respect. I would love to get your honest feedback on something that I'm really excited about. Maybe I'm missing something. I really would like your take on it. And again, you're always asking them to read the first three chapters. And while you're doing it, you're asking them if they would give you 30 minutes. And most people, when you're asking in these ways, will be happy to do that. They're flattered that you really want their feedback. And then again, it's getting their commitment to do it in a week or 2 weeks. But I would really not go longer than 2 weeks because, again, it's going to be, you know, everybody's going to forget about it. It's going to go home and sit on a nightstand somewhere and not get read. And then for that person too, that you really respect, you can say, I know that you are really happy with your life exactly the way it is, but you are exactly the kind of person that I would love to have as a business partner. And I'm just wondering if you would read the first three chapters of this book and maybe you will think of somebody that isn't as happy as you are, but that is like you because you're the kind of person that I would love to do this business with. And again, people are flattered by that. And then another example, and this was a situation that I was actually in. Sometimes you have someone that you just do not know how to get from here to there talking to them. And this would be good for anybody that's really kind of a tough one for you. I was going to a hormone doctor, and I was every time I went to her, she would talk about her kids and her grandkids and how much she loved to travel and all the things that she really enjoyed doing. And I kept sitting there thinking, how in the world can she stand coming to this office all the time? She needs to have the freedom that our business model would provide. And so I couldn't think of how to get from being the patient to the doctor and how to bridge that gap. So the next time that I came in to see her, I said, you know what, I have a really weird request for you. And she said, okay. And I said, I'm part of this little research project, and I need to find somebody that is super successful, a super successful female professional, and get their input on something. I have this book, and I'd like you to read the first three chapters of it. It'll take 30 minutes. Would you do that for me? And she said, oh, of course I would. And I kind of was making it up as I went, but actually, we are part of this little research project. We are part of understanding what people's perception of our profession is, and enlightening them, opening their mind, and dispelling the myths. And so what happened with her is that after a week, she hadn't read it, but again, she felt really guilty because she said she would. And so then I waited another week. And when I got back with her, after she had read it, she said, oh my gosh, there are no coincidences. I have had a girlfriend in Hawaii trying to talk to me about her network marketing business for years, and I wouldn't listen. I wanted nothing to do with it. And now I understand why she's been trying to talk to me about it. So truly, the outcome that I have had from every single situation has been really, really good. And then our second book, we have a second book called Does the Shoe Fit? And Does the Shoe Fit is, and again, what I look at these books as are tools in a toolbox. We all in network marketing, I believe, have a toolbox. And we have different resources that we pull out for different things. Sometimes we need information about the products. Sometimes we need samples of the products. Sometimes we want a book to give to somebody that has just joined the business. And there's lots of great books. And you know, I think in our business, we're always involved in personal development. And there's a lot of great books on personal development that are appropriate to our business. But these books are, this book connects with skeptics. It's the reason it's very effective at enlightening people. And the more of us that are giving this to people that don't understand our business, the more our business will be understood. And Does the Shoe Fit has a different use. So it basically is a book that I think is unique as well to the books that are out there, in that it bridges the gap between traditional 9-to-5 jobs and network marketing. I mean, those of us that are in this business know that they are two completely different worlds. I mean, corporate America operates very differently than network marketing. Most people are used to having to look over their shoulder and more of it being in a competitive environment. And working for a paycheck versus working for freedom are two completely different things. And so I think it's really important to set up the right expectations for people so that they're not going to get discouraged when they put in all that work at the very beginning and they don't see the results. I mean, this is a business that is about delayed gratification. And understanding that is really important. I think what happens too is that when we get into the business, a lot of times once we get it, we completely forget about how we felt before we got it. I mean, a lot of us were skeptical before, and all of a sudden it's like we see it and then we kind of forget about what it was like before. So this book really bridges the gap between people that have worked in traditional careers and now they're in network marketing, and it's a whole different ball game. The other thing that this book does is it has examples of career comparisons. So somebody that was a pharmaceutical rep, or somebody that was an attorney, or a nurse, it compares how what being a nurse compared to being a network marketer. What are the things that you learned as a nurse that apply to network marketing that will help you? What are the things that are different? What are the things that you're going to have to learn that you didn't know, that you didn't use in your other profession? So it's really kind of a practical guide for somebody to help them understand the differences between these two different career paths. And it's also a great book for somebody that thinks they've tried network marketing. I think what happens so many times, there's so many people out there that think they've tried network marketing. They were recruited by a friend. They kind of came in the back door. They never even really understood what they were doing. And maybe they didn't have instant success because maybe they didn't do anything except join and thought they were going to instantly be successful. And so now they walk away from network marketing. And that's the worst kind of person, because they think they've tried it. They think it just didn't work for them. But the truth is, they maybe didn't get into the right company. They didn't believe in the products. The timing wasn't right. They didn't treat it like a business. They didn't appreciate it. So this book really explains all of those things. And I had someone that I was meeting with, and I asked her to read the book. She had tried network marketing, and her feedback to me after she read the book was, "Oh my gosh, I totally understand why I didn't succeed. I was never excited about the product. It was something that her husband had gotten involved in after going to a meeting. She never really bought into it or got excited about it or understood it. And so she got out of it, and she was one of those people that were walking around saying, I've tried network marketing and it doesn't work for me." So it's a great book for clearing up kind of the two different worlds of network marketing and traditional careers. So that's basically what I wanted to share. I would love questions or feedback. How is this sitting with you guys as far as using this approach of being more intentional with using a book to open the door, open the conversation with people?
I think it makes perfect sense, actually, because I think it's the biggest hurdle, isn't it? It's what puts people off most. And sometimes people even take the step of joining your team and then still think, oh, it's too uncool, I've got too much of an ego, and they just don't kind of, get over that hurdle, do they?
Exactly. And what we have is it's what people want. The truth is that being able to work to not have to work, most people, I think, aren't even thinking about an exit plan. And so this is something that really everybody needs to be doing something to provide a way for them to continue earning money after they are no longer working. So it's something that I think once people understand it, they have a completely different feeling about it. They respect it more. And until people respect what we're doing, they're not going to take it as seriously as they are if they really understand it. So anybody else have any comments?
Yeah, I do. It's Callie. I think it also is a really nice way to take people off of the defensive, because you don't have to answer questions back and forth. The book is laying it out and, helping people see blind spots. Like if someone did join a network marketing company and they weren't successful, helping them see why they weren't.
Exactly.
So I think it's a nice way to do that.
Yes, good. Exactly. So what I'm doing also for all of you that have listened to this training, and I it truly is my absolute passion. I want more people to be enlightened about what network marketing really is and what it is not. And there's just so many misconceptions out there. So what I'm doing as well is offering the books at half price so that you can get them. And my hope is to really use them as a business building tool. Have it in your toolbox and out. And so just to take advantage of that offer, you would go to our website, which is theflipflopceo.com. We also have a Facebook page, a community there, and a lot of times I post quotes out of the book that will help substantiate the brilliance of network marketing. I looked up one this morning. One of my favorite quotes out of our book is Lauren's, And Lauren's quote is, with three small children, I had lots of reasons not to do this business, but I knew if I made my kids the excuse versus the reason, I would never know. And those are the kind of, these are the kind of posts that are on the Flip Flop CEO page that can be shared to your page as well. So it's all about really raising the awareness and helping people think about these things that they're not thinking about. So again, the flipflopceo.com, and then you just enter the code HALF, all caps, H-A-L-F, when you put the books in the cart, and you can get the books at that discount. The books are also available on Amazon. I just can't make that offer on Amazon. And the Flip Flop CEO is available on Audible. Both books are available on Kindle too. So if you have somebody that's out of state and you want to quickly get a book to them, you can share that on Audible or Kindle as well. So any other questions or anything that I can...
Awesome. Lisa, I have a question. Do you suggest that we first introduce our friends and family, people we're introducing to the business, first to the product before the business? And I'm talking specifically about the book, or should the book come first?
You know, I personally am, I really, and I don't want to get in too much in what your system is or how you all do it. I just think it's really good to educate people about the profession of network marketing, the business model first. Again, with people, when you're going home and you know, if it's a new rep and they're going home to talk to their circle of influence, their family, their friends, I think the challenge comes with network marketing. I think a lot of people have this perception of it that is inaccurate. And so I think that when you open up the lines of communication about that and get someone to understand that it's brilliant. It's a brilliant business model, and it makes so much more sense to use word of mouth advertising than, you know, listening to some spokesmodel that doesn't even use products. So I think when you can open that up, then you can, you know, talk about the products. So I think the objection typically when somebody goes home is more about the fact that they're getting into one of those things rather than that they're presenting these products, because the products are great. It's the business model of network marketing that gets in the way for people usually. So I'm a huge proponent of talking about this, and then as Lauren said in the very beginning, oh my gosh, your story is what's so important. It's sharing, you know, where were you on network marketing? Where were you on? One of the other stories in our book is by another gal who's in Juice Plus, who was a teacher. And she was teaching kids in, I think, college, marketing. And she was teaching them that network marketing was bad. And she didn't even have any experience with it. So when she found the products, she was looking for a way to buy the products without having anything to do with the network marketing side of it. And so I think it just, you know, brings to mind, I mean, now she's very successful in Juice Plus and got past all of that. And she, like me, feels horrible about all the negativity she had about it because she was wrong. Once she did her research, she discovered that she was wrong, just as I did. So I really believe that it's important for us to enlighten people about the business model, and, you know, and then we can talk more, we can have a real conversation then about the product. It can be like, oh my gosh, yeah, I never really thought I was going to get into network marketing, and these products were so amazing, and they happened to be attached to network marketing, and then I realized that's word of mouth advertising. That's a brilliant way to share products. So it's kind of, I hope that answers your question.
Yeah. Well, and you know, I get asked lots of times to join, you know, groups or books, you know, and yours is one of the first ones I really decided I loved the concept, you know, and I just think it addressed it super well. So I'm excited about it. I think it's great. As I shared, those of you that are on the call, I will personally get you one of one of the books. But I would suggest you get them, you know, for your team. I don't, you know that I don't normally suggest a lot of stuff, but I really think that this is a great book. I use it often, and I give it away to a lot of people as well. So I think it's a great way for us to, you know, get yourself, like she says, out of the picture and let, you know, let that do the book. And I love Janine's mindset, as you can tell, too. She uses that third-party approach, too. You know, like, I'm sure you're fine, but I'm sure you'll know somebody, you know, that if you happen to know somebody. So I love her approach. I just really align with it super well. So thank you for joining us. We've got a big boot camp coming up here this weekend. So I think most everybody other than my European guys and Australians that are going to be there, looks like, I don't know, no, Jen's not going to be there. Callie's going to be here, Karina. You've got a couple people that are out of the country. So those of you that are out of the country, we'll figure out how to get you your book. We've got like five on the line right now who are out of the country. But we do have, so thank you for joining us. I'm just going to take a couple minutes and go over some other stuff. You guys, how do you feel? Do you guys have any questions, any other questions or any distinctions from her sharing? Anyone? Or what you got from it? Anyone want to share? No? Okay.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'll share. It's Callie. I think it just reminds me, like, after you've been in the industry for a little bit, just remembering the difference between, you know, it is a competitive environment in the regular traditional, like, I'm a teacher, but I'm a coach, and there's, you know, a lot of jealousy amongst the teachers because there's only one coach, and I have more flexibility, you know, and it's just different. Like, people take credit for other people's work, and it's just a night and day difference in the industry of network marketing. So just listening to the examples that you provided, it's just like, wow, I kind of forgot about all those benefits. It's just a nice reminder.
Thank you. It is completely different. Completely different worlds.
So, guys, we have, as I shared, I'm going to share real quick about just boot camp this weekend. And those of you that aren't here at boot camp, as you guys know, I think that Natalie posted about the SC events that are taking place. Most of you were added to that SC, Fast Track to SC, the Year of the Qualified Leader Group. But in order to be in the Year of the Qualified Leader Group, you guys, you have to be qualified. So what that means is if you're not qualified yet, if you're not a VF or a 2SC yet, you need to make sure to get to VF get to SC so that you can be a part of that group. And unfortunately, today on the call, we were just talking about it, is that in order to really hold the standard of, you know, the year of the qualified leader, we have to go through and we have to see who is qualified and who is not qualified so that they can stay in that group the year of the qualified leader. You know, that's leverage for you. Your goal is to get qualified each month and then to get to be a POB qualified. So those of you that are coming to boot camp this weekend, really make sure that you you come prepared once again with you want to print out your PVC report. And so that you can understand that. It's pretty simple to understand, but we need to make sure you do understand about being qualified for your business. And the difference between being PB qualified and POB qualified, the difference is literally almost double your income. So, well, it is double your income when you're POB qualified versus PB qualified. So, you'll learn about it this weekend. You want to come this weekend really with questions. The goal of this weekend isn't for you just to come and, you know, take notes and all of those things. The goal is for you really to have your game plan moving forward, you know, with regards to that. So does anybody have any questions about boot camp and maybe some of those people that are on the line that are from Europe, since they won't be able to be here? Maybe you guys can right now, the people that aren't coming to boot camp, those of you that are coming to boot camp, if you can buddy up with one of these people that are on the line, because I don't think Beth's coming. I don't think that Jen Yorznick is coming. So if you can put, if you're not coming. Buddy up with one of those people. So can you guys put in the chat and just, you know, accept to be a buddy for somebody about what you've learned? Because Cheryl and myself, Jeff, are really going to take time this weekend to meet with you guys and put together your plan. But we need to make sure you come prepared with your list, some profile sheets of people. You want to come once again with, you know, just looking at your, who is your team? What you got to work with? And once again, it's a lot easier to give birth than raise the dead, as we know. So who are those potential team members that you have? Who are those people that you think just need, you know, a game plan as well? But once again, you know, as I shared on the you're the qualified leader, you know, and I learned this from Lisa Gross to my left, it says, I'll help you build your business, meaning I'll help, comma, you build your business. It's your business, right? We're resources, myself, Cheryl, Jeff, you know, lots of different resources out there, the books. But you, to build your business, it all starts with really, really building a wide front line and not just putting on customers, but really putting on that team. You know, I was just up in Calgary with Carrie LeBlanc's team and everything. And, you know, we just talked about, you know, what really needs to happen. And every person needs to go wider with their business. There's momentum in it. Like, look at that. It happens even on the call like this. When there's 20 of you on the call, right, the more numbers that there are, the excitement goes up. So does anybody have any questions about this weekend or anything about the call today? Anyone?
Lauren, can you just clarify what to bring to boot camp? You said print out the PVC profile sheets.
Yeah, you want to print out the PVC, your PVC report, right? You want to print out it, you can go print out your report. And then you want to print out, you know, some profile sheets to fill the name.
Your brand.
Were you on the qualified leader call? Okay. I'll send it. I'll post it. Right. Anyway, I'll post what to bring you guys. Okay. I'll post what to bring to boot camp. All right. Bye, everyone.
Bye, thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.